Hi, it's Ty the Real Estate Guy, and today I'm going to talk about how the COVID-19 coronavirus has changed the mortgage industry. I'll answer the questions, should I refinance right now, and should I buy a house right now? I will also give a quick explanation of mortgage forbearance and tell you what I think. Should you take it or should you leave it? By the way, if this is your first time seeing me, you'll want to hit the subscribe button below and ring that little bell to stay up to date on the latest real estate tips and trends. Sorry, I've got to ask, is anyone else sick of this coronavirus quarantine? Personally, I'm about to lose my mind. I would love for things to just return to normal, but with several weeks gone by now since the coronavirus outbreak and the quarantine, there have been major changes to the real estate and especially the mortgage industry. We are living in unprecedented times where mortgage rates are changing sometimes on an hourly basis. Truly, these are chaotic times, and it's my goal to eliminate some of the confusion so you can make an educated decision. So let's get started. I know that loads of you are wondering if you should refinance at this time. Before I answer this question, there's a few questions you need to ask yourself. First, why do you want to refinance? Are you trying to decrease your monthly payment? Are you trying to slice some years off your mortgage by going with a shorter term loan, even if it increases your monthly mortgage payment? Or are you just looking to pull some cash out? The other question you should be asking is, how stable is my current situation? Obviously, if you're worried about the permanence of your job, you probably shouldn't buy a home, but in the same situation, a refinance could be very helpful, and refinancing could be the difference between losing your home or keeping it. Also remember that closing costs will add up to thousands of dollars. That means you'll need to do some math here. Find out how much you are saving per month, or in other words, how much lower will your new mortgage payment be? Divide total cost of savings per month to show how long it will take for you to pay off what the refinance ends up costing you. For instance, if the refinance costs you $4,500 and it reduces your payment by $150 per month, it will take you 30 months or 2.5 years to pay off that refi. If you're planning to stay in your home for several years, then from this standpoint, the refinance was a great idea. If you sell your home a year or two later, then the refinance will have actually put you in a worse financial situation. You'll also need to consider how far along you are in your current mortgage. If you don't know this already, every time you make a mortgage payment, a larger portion of your payment is applied to paying off your principal. If you're 7 years into your current mortgage, refinancing back to a 30-year mortgage could be a bad thing because, yes, most likely, you'll be reducing your monthly payment, but the negative is that you're resetting back to a 30-year term, which means it will most likely take you longer to pay off your house, and the amount being applied to your principal will be greatly reduced. Some financial advisors believe it's better to just apply what you'd be paying in closing costs towards paying down your principal. This would help you pay off your home faster. It's definitely something to consider. You also have the option to do a cash out refi. Usually, I don't recommend doing this, but if you need to pay off some major credit card debt or pay off a vehicle, maybe finish your basement, or even put a little money in reserves because your income has been greatly reduced, it could potentially be helpful. But once again, this should be a last resort or only done in emergencies. Really? Your goal should be to pay off your home as quickly as possible. In some ways, buying a home is like a prison sentence. For the next 30 years, you're tied to that ball and chain. Every time you make a mortgage payment, you're one step closer to being freed. But a cash out refinance is going to add some serious time to your sentence, and you really need to evaluate if that's worth it. Instead, you should be looking for ways to reduce your sentence with some good behavior. Fortunately, there are some simple and creative ways to quickly pay down your home. Yes, I have a video to explain this, but let's get back to the subject. Currently, Mortgage rates are crazy low, but at this time, you'll really need to shop around. Yes, you'll want to go through the full loan approval process with two or maybe three different lenders. That means you'll need each one of these lenders to pull your credit so they can give you hard numbers on the rate they can give you and your closing costs. A lot of people are worried about hurting their credit by having it pulled multiple times, but I have some good news for you. From the first time you have your credit pulled for a home mortgage, you have 45 days to get your credit pulled from other lenders, and your credit score will only get dinged that one time. All credit pulls will show up on your history, but once again, you will only get hit for that first inquiry. In other words, if you're ready to buy a house and you really want to get the best terms on a home loan, you'll want to go through the full approval process with multiple lenders. Before I continue, can I ask a quick favor? Will you please give this video a thumbs up? I would appreciate that more than you know, and that thumbs up will help others see that this video is helpful. Thanks. Okay, so the biggest question most people are asking right now is if they should refinance or buy a home now or wait a few weeks or even months. If I'm being 100% honest, no one knows what mortgage rates will be a few months or weeks or really in this market, who knows what the rates will be in the next few hours. That being said, rates are expected to stay low. But because mortgage rates are amazing right now, I'd look into it right now. And just to be completely transparent, I personally just refinanced to a 15-year mortgage. Yes, my payment increased, but I just deleted 6 years off my prison sentence, aka my mortgage. How did I lock in the lowest rate possible? I called my lender and told him, if rates take a big dip, lock us in. He had me fill out a loan application online. I sent him all of my information, but told him to hold off on pulling my credit until we were fully committed. When rates took that huge drop on March 10th, he called me and said, I would lock in right now. I did, and the rest is history. This is the approach I would normally recommend, but because rates are currently near the all-time lows, I'd recommend talking to a lender right now. If it makes sense to refinance right now, then you should do it right now. For those of you that don't know, when you lock the rate, the lender cannot charge you a higher rate. But if rates go down a little further, you cannot drop to the new lower rate. So you want to use some caution when you lock. Once again, because rates are so amazing right now, I would lock something in right now. If rates increase or decrease by an eighth or even a quarter point, it's not going to change your monthly payment that much. You can have your lender do the math on your loan at different rates if that makes you feel better. A lot of people are wondering if they should buy a home right now. Obviously, you need to look at your current situation. Is your job stable? Do you have plenty of cash in reserves? If you're in a great spot, I would say yes. If things are tight and you're working hard to qualify, you may want to hold off, especially if you're not 100% sure if your employment is stable. For those of you who are ready, this is an incredible time to buy a house because you don't have a lot of competition and there are people out there who are desperate to sell their homes. But obviously, there's some real risk here. If this quarantine goes on for another 6 months or longer, bad things will happen. House prices will fall because people will start losing their homes. But if we're out of this coronavirus quarantine in a month or two, you may look back and realize that you missed a huge opportunity. For an in-depth look at if you should buy a home right now, watch my video, Should You Buy a Home During the Coronavirus Pandemic? I'll put a link to this video below. Okay, so let's talk about mortgage forbearance real quick. Mortgage forbearance is not mortgage forgiveness. It's relief for those people who've lost their job or income. With mortgage forbearance, you're still required to make those missed mortgage payments. They're just giving you a short reprieve. There are still some questions surrounding mortgage forbearance, but as it sits right now, your lender could require that you pay the whole thing back all at once in the near future. Before you skip a payment, you will want to contact your lender and go over your options. They may require that you pay the whole thing back all at once, or you may be able to set up a payment plan. But I think you'll want to avoid mortgage forbearance if at all possible, because the skip payments will show up on your credit as missed payments. That means mortgage forbearance will hurt your ability to buy a home in the future, at least the near future. It could also hurt your ability to get the best rates or terms on future loans. Once again, talk with your lender before you start skipping payments, because if you don't set up forbearance with your lender, you're just delinquent. Your lender will work with you. They don't want you to lose the home, so they will do what they can to help. But if you miss too many payments, the bank will absolutely take that home from you. So avoid mortgage forbearance if possible. I know that for many of you, this is a scary time. There's a lot riding on your ability to make that mortgage payment. I went through some tough times myself back in 2008 when the market crashed. And I know that many of you don't have this option, but before you go to the bank, ask your family or friends for help. On a few different occasions back in 2008, I had asked my dad for a few hundred dollars to cover the rest of my mortgage payment with a promise I would pay him back, which of course I did as soon as possible. Maybe try this option before calling your bank. If you're thinking about buying a house for yourself or as an investor, due to the forbearance, there may be some great opportunities a few months down the road, but that is a different video for another day. If you're ready to buy a home, be sure to check out my video, which tells you everything you need to know to get a home loan. I'll put a link to this video below. Is there something in this video that really stood out to you as being helpful? If so, what was it? Please let me know by commenting below. If you have questions, or if I left something out, please help the community by leaving a remark below as well. Sincerely, I want to hear from you. And if you know someone who's wondering if they should refinance or buy a home, please share this video with them. For more great real estate videos, please hit the subscribe button below. Also, you can find me on Instagram at Ty the Real Estate Guy. If you found this information helpful, please give me a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to ring that little bell below. It'll make you feel good.